Let me just tell you one thing. I've been spending a lot of time in the south, but so don't mess with me, bro. Okay.
Can come over here and say that.
No, no, I'll get my guys to come over and say that.
Get out from behind me.
No,
but say it from behind my chair.
My guys will come and say it.
Yeah, bring your oaks. Yeah.
Okay. Right. The reason why I'm speaking like that is because this prank takes place in the south of Johannesburg. It's an absolutely wonderful part of the world. I get an email from a guy. He says, "Please prank my best mate, Darren Lane." His name subsequently is Daryl Morris. So there's lots of Darrens and Daryls around. He says, "Last week we had a poker evening at his girlfriend's flat in Alberton."
Now, hold on. One of our hot jocks here, Roxy Berger, has just put her hands right over her face.
Do you know this dude?
Do you know this guy?
Candace put on a really good poker evening.
Yes, last week. Candace!
Candace Shepherd, yes.
Yes!
I know them all. Hello, Darren.
Were you there?
No, I wasn't. But I heard about them.
No, I wasn't, she says. I was nowhere near there. In fact, I don't even know those people. I'm not actually from the south at all.
Okay, so they put on a poker evening.
And basically what happens is they order pizzas.
Right.
And now Darren's got a five-year-old kid who's starving. It's 7 o'clock. They order pizza. The pizza, they ordered it at 7. It comes at 10:30.
Right.
Whoa.
So he's fuming. Now, this is the funniest part of the story to me. He's phoning them, telling them that he's gonna moor them, basically, okay?
Yeah.
And he's not gonna pay. So now the poor driver rocks up.
Okay.
So Candace locks him
away
in the bathroom.
Right. As good move, Candace.
Yeah.
Because she doesn't want any altercation. She says, "Look, you know what? I'm just gonna go and pay the guy."
Yeah.
So he climbs out the bathroom window.
No, he doesn't.
This is so sad.
Runs up to this dude, is about to hook him a shot, and the girlfriend Candace gets involved and eventually says, "You're not paying the guy. I'm just going to give him 20 bucks and that's it." They ordered 3 pizzas. All right. And he's really most upset about the fact that his kid has gone to bed hungry.
Yeah.
He didn't consider whipping him up something himself.
Well, we're going to get
there. Sorry, it is the south. Yeah, okay.
Now this is a pizza place in the south, but we do things a little bit different, eh?
Okay.
Hello, Darren speaking.
Hi there, my name's Jan Bardnos. I'm calling from Hereville.
Yes.
The reason why I'm calling, Darren, I'm sure you are aware of the incident 2 Thursdays ago about the money that you owe us.
The money that I owe you guys?
Yes. When will we be able to make the payments?
We're not going to be making the payments.
And why is that?
Because we ordered the food at 7 o'clock. Must have been about 10 past 7. The food was delivered to us at 5 to 10. The food came freezing cold, and we won't pay for that.
There was a problem that happened on the night, and we did say that we would give you your next order free.
And well, what is an apology got to do that if a 5-year-old's waiting at home to get food? What has that got to do with anything?
At
10 o'clock at night for food to arrive.
You're telling me that you're feeding your 5-year-old pizza?
Yes, he does eat pizza.
You think pizza's a substantial diet for a 5-year-old?
If everybody's having that once a week, why can't he have it?
Well, look,
what has that got to do with this argument? Where's your manager? Are you the manager there?
Yes, I am.
Because you're quite a smart ass, I won't lie.
Really?
You're quite a smart ass.
I mean, are you too lazy as a parent to actually make your kid something?
You know what? Give me a number so I can get my lawyer to sign you now.
Oh, your lawyer.
Give me a number.
Yes. No. You know what? We
no,
hear
no, no, no. We're going to get this involved further. Give me a number.
Look, this is going to go further. So you've got one of two options here. Pay the money or suffer the consequences.
What consequences?
Because I'm sick and
tired. Listen, you asshole. Give me your name.
Listen, I'm sick and tired of customers like you that think you can push around our drivers.
I'll come to your shop now and I'll you up. That's what I'll do.
Oh, you will, really?
Yes, I will. You could argue my son and my parents' skills. The most important thing is whether my son eats or not. No matter what it is, your service is to get the f***ing food to my house, which you didn't do. Do you understand me?
Well, listen. Like
do you understand me? We support your f*** of a service, which is shocking. And I won't pay for that meal.
Well, listen.
I won't. My lawyer, they're going to be contacting you very shortly, and I want your name and your number.
Yeah, like you have a lawyer on speed dial, I'm sure.
I'm actually, my girlfriend works at a law firm, f***hole.
You obviously thinking of yourself as quite a man.
And where are you from?
Where am I from?
Yeah, well, Samson.
No, I'm not.
So where are you from?
I'm from Glen Vista. Let me just tell you that should this bill not be paid, then you are going to have problems that are, let's just say, outside of the law. We don't get lawyers involved here.
So is that a threat that you're going to send someone to me up. Is that what you're going to do?
It's not a threat. It's more of gentle persuasion.
Oh, a gentle warning.
Yes.
Who are you going to get? Who the f*** are you going to get? Huh?
Well...
Because you live in Glen Vista, now you're going to get someone to come f*** me up.
Well...
Why don't you go and f*** yourself? That's what you can go and do. Whether you're going to send somebody to come f*** me up, I'll tell you what, I'll meet you there now. You...
You...
Can you believe it?
Yeah. I'm giving you one last option to pay for the pizzas.
After a threat like this, I won't be paying for nothing. Is this the kind of service you have to offer?
Well, you know what, you will be...
I'm going straight to the papers with it.
You know
I promise you now that I've been threatened with my life.
You know what you will be paying for is your hospital bills.
Can you believe this shit? You just wacky f***ing sister.
You are damn straight, dude.
You f***ing joking. I just got caught by f***ing wacky sister.
Listen, brother, you've got your mate Daryl to thank.
Daryl, where's he?
He's out of...
I just got f***ed by wacky sister, you little...
Let's call your mate right now.
Okay.
Yo.
Hello?
Yo, Daryl.
Daryl, you piece of it. What happened? You just f***ed up my whole day, bro. I've never been abused in my life like that, bro.
Oh, that is funny.
Not going to go to a poker evening at their house.
No, ever.
Ever.
And Roxy, you're not to go there again,
yeah,
either.
Roxy Berger, you disassociate yourself from those.